as President of America. Where he was informed, words came out of his mouth, "There cannot be better fun than this." But immediately he decided, when I am nominated, maybe it is God's wish and I have to work. And he started working very hard. If I become the President, I will be doing this, I will be doing that, I will be doing that. If I am given a chance, then I will be serving the people who are suffering. And he gave the example, so many presidents were there, they could not do much. And really did the work for the poor. He removed slavery from America. Yet by accepting the enmity of the whole nation, and today he is considered to be the best president of America. The words he used at the lecture after the war was over, when the speech was given by him, that speech is engraved in gold on a wall. And American people are spending $16,000 a month as security guards so that nobody should steal away the gold and the wall should remain as it is. There was something in his words. And if you read those words, you'll be enlightened. What was the education of Lincoln? When he became President of America, a question was asked to him, "Sir President, what is your education?" And he replied, "Defective." Second question was asked, "Sir President, what do I understand by the word defective?" And he said, "I learned in 13 schools for a total period of 9 months. And the third question was asked, "Why was it so? I had no money to pay the fees. I used to get admission in the school, remain there for 15-20 days, study without paying fees, and then I would be removed, sent out. But in the meantime, 15-20 days time, I made friends at the school. School boys were studying there. I take their address. And when they go home, I go to them, what was taught in the school, and I would learn from them. Those boys would become my teacher, and that is my education." So many people complain that we don't have circumstances to develop ourselves further and further. We are suffering because of our circumstances. In India, our leadership provides, Gandhiji, he was the son of a grocer. Sardar Patel was the son of a farmer. Subhash Chandra Bose was the son of a clerk, a philosopher. Swami Vivekananda was the son of an ordinary lawyer. Except Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru, all of them came from lower middle class. And they achieved many things in life. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru was the son of a very rich person, Motilal Nehru, very rich person. His clothes were sent to Paris for washing. You can imagine. But the discipline that was there in the family for Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru was the worst. Motilal Nehru was very strict. At the age of 9, he was sent to Oxford. When Jawaharlal's mother objected, Motilal said, "I am not going to listen to anything. You are pampering the child and spoiling his future life. I want to be a better leader than me, and I want him to be the future Prime Minister of India." That was the vision. And he studied there. He became a barrister. So circumstances may be favorable to a few people, some people here, but otherwise everybody has worked very, very hard. In spite of failure, they have come up. So what I would say is never worry about your failures. Failures are the experience that you get for not to repeat such mistakes again. Gandhiji, he used to work 18 hours a day. I am not concerned with his politics. Some of you may be against it and all that. That is not concern. Our concern is self-development. An ordinary person who became a barrister, and from that he became a not only a national leader but a world leader. What was the development? He developed himself with discipline every minute. If you read his diary, diary written by Mahadev Desai, you will find so many examples there. How strict he was about everything. And self-discipline was the first thing he imposed on himself. He said discipline for the next person afterwards. If somebody makes a mistake in the ashram, he would ask himself, what is lacking in my education, what is lacking in my discipline that this man has made a mistake? And he would find out the reason why this has happened. So self-development also requires self-discipline. They all fought against all odds of life. Throughout Lincoln's life, not a single day was a happy day. If you read his book, Unknown Lincoln, written by Dale Carnegie, you will find every day was an unhappy day for him. His wife was a woman who would be quarreling with him every minute. It happened once that the war was going on and an emergency meeting was called at the house of Lincoln, presidential house. Lincoln had the habit of consuming coffee at 9 o'clock at night. Meeting was going on and he sent the message, prepare the coffee for me and I'll come inside. Otherwise the coffee will serve to everybody. His wife prepared the coffee. And she sent the message with the son, tell Debbie that the coffee is ready, getting cold. And Lincoln said, I am just coming. Second message was sent after 5 minutes. Lincoln said, I am coming. He was absorbed in arguments. And when you are absorbed in arguments, you forget everything. You are thinking about the next argument and next argument. And Lincoln's wife, Mary, came in the room where the meeting was going on. And threw the coffee on the face of Lincoln. Here is your coffee. Just imagine what would happen. A man who is the president and the wife behaving like this. Lincoln did not say a word. He said, gentlemen, I am sorry. Give me a few minutes. Excuse me. I'll return back. He went to bathroom, washed his face, came back, and resumed the talk. You can imagine what type of wife she must be. She would insult him even in public. Once Lincoln was sitting in the Victoria. The Victoria was there at that time. Cars are not there, Lincoln's time. And the man who fought the war, civil war, the commander in charge, Mr. Grant, his wife came there and sat next to Lincoln. Mary came there, touched the hand of Mrs. Grant. Don't you feel shameful? You are sitting next to my husband. That is my seat. Now when such things are happening, what would happen? But he endured everything. And he was busy only with his own progress. Odds are there in life. Everybody will have odds. Every one of you will have odds. Every one of you will complain about circumstances and this and that, but we have to be alert, self-vigilant, self-disciplined, and go ahead. How many times Gandhiji failed in Satyagraha? He started Satyagraha in 1921, 22, 24, 27, 30, 33, 34, 35, 42 last. And during 42 Satyagraha, he lost his secretary, Mahadev Desai. He lost his wife, Kasturba. He was all alone. But even then, he worked and worked. He never lost his temperament. And ultimately, what we got? Independence of India. Freedom from the Britishers. Whether we are happy or not is a different thing. The freedom didn't come. Now, what was the first thing with these people who were developing?